Buddy, tell the whole truth anymore?
I lied on my resume.
Lies cost her a job.
No one had ever gone to the lengths she had gone to.
Why did you do it?
I did it to get into the country, to get a special talent visa.
If people didn't lie, we'd be out of business.
That's Bill.
A lie may cost this woman her life.
That's how you found out?
Yeah.
How could you love somebody and not tell them that you were HIV positive?
I was very unhappy, and it came to a crisis.
Lies almost cost these people their marriage.
Yes, truth-telling has saved our marriage.
Advertising, may I help you?
Men and women feel pressure to lie to get each other interested.
How true is this?
6-foot attractive Jewish male.
We'll take you along on a blind date and find out.
Hi.
Hi.
Lying. We don't like it in our politicians or in our kids. According to a recent 48 Hours New York Times poll, an overwhelming majority of Americans, 7 in 10, believe lying is never justified. But when's the last time you told a lie? Think about it. Lying is a lot more common in everyday life than most of us would like to admit. Most of these lies, of course, are the little deceptions we tell to ease social situations. But others, quite literally, can be a matter of life or death.
This is an every morning affair. Get up obscenely early and drag myself out of bed. And then be really perky for 4 hours.
Smoking in the boys' room, compliments of the crew on Rock 103 XZL. Thanks for turning us on.
Just when everything seemed to be going well for disc jockey Karin Begin, she had a rude awakening.
Shannon Rock on Rock 103 XZL.
These days, she's known as Shannon Rock, and she works for a small radio station near Baltimore.
Rock 103 XEL, the only morning show in Baltimore that has balls, even though the host is Christmas.
She used to have a radio show in a much larger city, Philadelphia. That was before she lied to her boss and was fired.
I lied on my resume. Show me an actress who hasn't lied on her resume, and I'll show you a waitress.
Karin wasn't interested in waiting tables or doing anything else in Canada, where she was born.
A couple minutes after 8, I'm Shannon Rock. Welcome to my wanton and reckless disregard for good taste and convention.
What she wanted was to be on the radio in America.
Animal Bag, I love this tune.
Why did you do it?
I did it to get into the country, to get a special talent visa. Radio is not considered special talent. Unless you can play hockey or you're Michael J. Fox, you cannot get your paws on a special talent visa. I got angry and frustrated, and I went to an agent, and I said, okay, here's the deal. I want to go to America. How are we going to do it?
Bottom line, you look up in the dictionary, we lied.
Kevin Carver was Karin's agent in Canada.
And she made up some beautiful, plausible movie titles and television show titles that she could have starred in.
So what did they make up? They said that Karin had a feature role in the Canadian television series Hanging In. She now says she had a bit part in 3 episodes. They said she was in the comedy Meatballs.
Really?
That was a lie. They said she was in the horror movie Happy Birthday to Me. That was also a lie.
Did you have the sense that you were doing anything out of the ordinary?
No, not really. If you were to start looking at the careers of many of the top stars in North America, you would find at some point in time that there had been some sort of a deception that would have taken place.
Show business is the art of make-believe.
Celebrity columnist Cindy Adams has heard it all, usually during lunch at New York's Russian Tea Room.
I get it all the time.
You get lies all the time. Big lies?
Not such big lies. They're white lies. They're lies. They're lies to save their face. They're lies to save their future. They're lies of desperation.
And these are big stars, right? I mean, we're not talking about small-time people here. I mean.
Look, Sylvester Stallone wears built-up heels. Linda Evans has hair extensions. Burt Reynolds has a toupe. Barbara Hershey has had collagen in her lips. That's what they do. It's not reality, it's unreality.
But is it a lie?
It ain't the truth.
Is there such a thing as an actress or a disc jockey or an actress who does not lie?
Yes, they pretty much do things like, hey, like fries with that?
When Karin Begin decided to lie on her resume, she knew the practice was common, but she may not have known how common. In a recent survey of high school and college students, 30% of those questioned said if they had to, if it meant the difference between getting a job and not getting a job, they would lie on their resumes.
Good morning, Fidelifax.
Mary, who would I speak to verify that someone worked there back in 1983?
If people didn't lie, we'd be out of business.
Tom Norton is president of Fidelifax. He makes a living investigating people's backgrounds.
Yeah, these are all people that are being checked for employment purposes.
This is for employment.
Fidelifax provides its services for companies nationwide.
Right.
Out of 100 resumes that you check, how many will you find problems with?
Oh, probably 30, 35%.
Degree have a BA in mathematics, received June of 65.
It comes down to being honest. If they're not straight with you, when you're hiring them, I mean, how much can you trust them when they're working for you?
This one radio disc jockey who we spoke to says, show me an actress who doesn't pad her resume and I'll show you a waitress.
I wish I'd said that, and I probably will. That you show me somebody who hasn't padded themselves here or a resume or anything else. Who cares as long as she's entertaining?
704 with Shannon Rock. If you don't like me, you're not paying attention.
Were you reluctant at all when you sat down to write the inflated resume?
See, now the good Karin wants to say, yes, I was. I had a lot of sleepless nights. But the bad Karin just wants to tell you, hell no. We had a ball with that resume.
The party ended when Karin got caught. 6 months after entering the country, her lies were exposed in a Philadelphia Magazine article.
When I saw the article, the day that I read the article, I passed out.
When she recovered, she lied again, this time to cover her tracks.
No one had ever lied to me, I guess, as extensively. No one had ever gone to the lengths she had gone to.
Philadelphia Inquirer reporter Joe Logan was just one of those who came to her defense.
I talked to her for 2 hours. I sat down with her in the office of the radio station.
Logan believed what Karin said, so he wrote a newspaper column defending her against the magazine piece.
She had names to call. What I did not know at the time was that she was methodically going through this list, calling these people in Canada, saying, a reporter from the Philadelphia Inquirer will be calling you. Please verify what I'm telling him.
And then, to make sure, Karin provided more proof.
From Canada, a letter from the Magi Tutorial Service in Toronto, which says, please be advised that Ms. Karin Begin has received regular tutelage from our agency for the past several months on the set of Hanging In.
Is this true? Is this her?
No, this is completely bogus. There is no
such. I think the bottom line is, if you have the talent to be where you are, then it just doesn't matter how you got there, as long as you don't hurt other people. And I didn't hurt other people. It was never my intention.
Who gets hurt? Ultimately, her radio station certainly was embarrassed. They had all band together to support her. They had rallied. They were very embarrassed. We as a newspaper, certainly our credibility is on the line.
You must either really love me or you're incredibly stupid.
Does the lying ever stop?
I think not until the world stops and everybody wants to get off. That's a human trait.
And so ends another morning of fun and frolic with the raven-haired radio wench. Actually, that's not true anymore, is it? What am I now? What am I this week?
You still look red to me.
Yeah.